for Tucson, what are some recommendations that you have on making streets safer here? Because there's been a lot of fatalities lately. Based on your research, what do you think?
Yeah. Well, Tucson, first of all, is considered America's best laboratory of putting in new treatments for pedestrians. More treatments have been put in Tucson than any other city of size anywhere. But Tucson is a city of great speed. The streets are too wide. There's a lot of sprawl. It's almost like endless sprawl. And with those conditions, even the best crossings aren't all that you need. So we're looking at ways that we can define how do we make an area, an important area like the campus, one that walking is successful, and then start to apply additional measures that will help us get there. A very good example, when we look at 6, it has more lanes than it may need. And we might want to look seriously at how do we manage traffic using brand new tools that are being tried in many other cities in the nation. One is called a road diet. As we take unnecessary lanes away from the road and still keep traffic moving, we may need new tools at intersections to keep the traffic moving. So we'll be looking at those kinds of conditions and really make it easy to get across the street and safe, but really to bring down the speeds. The speeds are way too high in most parts of Tucson, way too high.
I believe there were like 17 pedestrian fatalities last year. Is that a normal number for a city of this size, or is that alarming to you?
The fact that you've had 17 fatalities is just off the charts. You are really experiencing a lot of tragedies that you shouldn't be having. And as I've been looking at what those fatalities have been, they appear to be random events, but they're not. There's a pattern. Many of them are tied to speed. They're all happening under almost ideal conditions. There are some that are low light or whatever. But when we start to look for the patterns, it's really the things that are popping out are the design of the streets overall and the speed of the streets. And those are the things that are going to have to be worked out over a number of years.
Tucson's not a very well-lit town in certain parts because of the university's focus on astronomy and studying the skies. Could that be a role or play a factor in these accidents?
The fact that there isn't an abundance of lighting at night can be a very serious problem. And so as we analyze traffic crashes, we want to figure out what we can change in terms of lighting, especially where people cross streets, but also what kind of clothing people wear. When people go out for a walk, they should understand that even white is not enough. And if you're jogging at night, motorist headlights will only find a pedestrian about 220 feet out. If the motors are doing 40 miles an hour, they will not see the pedestrian in time. So we have a lot of education that has to occur, but certainly when you get to a pedestrian-rich environment like a university campus, the speeds have to come down.